Hello everybody, my name is Denis and we are starting the next episode of Close to Algo Trading. In the last episode I promised you to show the useful example with the TensorFlow serving.
I've decided to split this video in two parts, because the full examples takes quite a long time. In the first part, we will see how to label data for a supervised learning algorithm. And in the part 2, we will create a simple model with the TensorFlow. We'll see how to export our model and use it with the TensorFlow serving. Today we are going to look at the following example. We will use a simple moving average strategy that generates open signals. These signals define the site, long and short. We will use stop loss and take profit levels to exit from the position. But in this situation, we also want to know if it makes sense to open this position at all. In other words, we want to know how big is the probability that the price will touch our profit level. For this case, we will create a simple binary classification model that will give us this probability. But for our model, we need a feature dataset and target labels. To label our features, we will use 1 if the price touches the profit level and 0 if it doesn't. I prepared a Python notebook where I will solve these tasks. Let's have a look on it. First of all, we need to import several Python modules. I am going to use Panda Data Reader to get the historical price data. Here we get the Apple price from Yahoo service for the last 19 years. Let's check our data and plot the adjusted closing price. The simple moving average strategy generates the signals to open the position when the fast moving average crosses the slow one. For calculating the simple moving average, we can use the rolling window. 5 last prices for the fast one and 10 for the slow one. Then let's define the two functions to get our crossing events. Now we got all events when fast moving average crosses the slow one from up to down and vice versa. Here you can see all our events. We have 2043 up and 2042 down events. Now we can define the site of our position. If we have a crossing up event, we will set 1 as our site label. And for the crossing down, we will set a minus 1. Cross events contains all data time of our crossing events. Here I define the function metalabeling. This function implements the triple barriers method for data labeling, but we will use only 2 barriers, stop loss and take profit. The function returns first touch level, row return, percent return, and the site of the position. Here, if the stop level is touched first, we set minus 1 to the touch TP variable. If the take profit is touched, we set 1. I am going to use 1.5% of the price change for the take profit and 1% for the stop loss, just to get more events. After execution of this function, we got our labels in the touch TP columns. Let's merge our results with the price table, just to have everything in one dataset. As we will use our labels in the binary classification model, let's change them to 1 if we touch take profit level and 0 if not. Let's select some features for training dataset. As target labels, we are going to use the values from the touchTP column. Well, we are done with the data labeling and preparing the training dataset. In the part 2, we will create the model and deploy it with the TensorFlow serving. Check the next video.